So let's start by settling the body, finding a comfortable, stable, upright position serviceable for meditation. So we keep our feet flat and our back straight, torso open, hands in the lap, right over left, with the palms upturned and the thumbs gently touching. Our eyes are gently closed or slightly open. Our gaze is unfocused and slightly downward. We try to maintain an awareness of not slouching or leaning. We also relax the body into a comfortable upright position, letting go of unnecessary tension in the body. Cultivate a sense of holding the awareness just to the body and mind. Not contacting objects of awareness in your environment. Allowing the outside world to be as it is. Start to concentrate your awareness in the present by attending closely to the physical sensations of the air moving into and back out of the tip of the nostrils. Noticing quickly when anything other than that one physical sensation is arising in the mind, and without judgment or frustration, lifting your attention up, gently but firmly placing it back again and again on the breath. Then when the mind feels more calm, generate a broad and altruistic motivation. Wanting to use your time to tap into your innate potential for spiritual growth and development. Cultivating beneficial, constructive states of mind. Reducing states of mind that cause oneself to suffer and motivate actions that harm others. And then try to turn your attention to the mind, spending a moment just noticing the river of mental events that arise in the mind. And then start with one specific moment slightly earlier this morning. could be breakfast if you've eaten, or conversation. Could be returning an email. Try to pick one memory. And try to think about your state of mind in that moment. Did you feel relaxed or stressed, hurried, eager? Was there a sense of dread or aversion? And try to track that mind back. Try to see if you can find connections. 5 minutes earlier, 10 minutes earlier, half an hour. Or any connections to last night, yesterday. Try to begin tracking the mind back. Following the causal thread. Just start looking for relationships. Patterns. In thoughts and actions. Observing the mind in the past week, past month, past year. Try to track the mind back further. Five years, 10 years, 20 years. Years. Thinking about major decisions, the arising of interests, stable patterns, trying to get a clear sense of this causal continuity of mind. And then return to the present and the recent past, thinking about the interests, the decisions that you're intentionally cultivating now. Those that seem constructive and those that seem not constructive. And try to follow the mind forward in time as one applies oneself to intentionally growing those beneficial constructive states and intentionally reducing those unconstructive habits and tendencies, states of mind. Try to follow that unfolding of one's own potential. Make a strong determination to engage in the decisions and actions that will bring about that flourishing of your own potential. And try to rest your mind in that determination. And then when you're ready, we'll come back together. And we'll dedicate. So recollect your altruistic motivation and think that having contemplated in this way, you've actualized that motivation, created positive energy in the mind. Have a sense of offering that positive energy for the benefit of all sentient beings, without exception. Thinking strongly, may it ripen in whatever way is truly beneficial for sentient beings. May it serve as a cause and condition to eliminate war and conflict, poverty, disease, natural disasters, all painful inner and outer conditions. May it fully ripen the minds of sentient beings. May they quickly meet perfect, qualified teachers and perfect their minds and arise in the state of enlightenment. May I too achieve that state of enlightenment so I might benefit sentient beings perfectly. May any obstacles facing the Guru's long life be completely dispelled. And may I and all sentient beings in this moment come under the joyful care and guidance of enlightened beings. May we be guided and protected until we swiftly achieve that state of enlightenment. Thank you.